Vielen herzlichen Dank, Marc. Das war sehr, sehr spannend. Als nächstes und letzten Redner vor den Fragen und vor dem Mittagessen. Ich weiß, wir sind ein bisschen in Verzug. Walter wird das alles aufholen, ich bin mir ganz sicher. Walter Penge, angereist aus Argentinien. Ich freue mich ganz, ganz herzlich, ihn hier heute begrüßen zu können. Walter leitet das Fachgebiet für Ökologie des Metropolitan Institute an der Universität Nacional in Buenos Aires. Er ist der Direktor des postgraduierten Studiengangs zur Umweltökonomie und Professor für Landschaftsökologie und Umweltschutz. Er ist außerdem Mitglied des UNEP Resource Panels, des Panels for Sustainable Resource Management und von Hause aus Agrarwissenschaftler, spezialisiert auf Pflanzengenetik und Pflanzenzüchtung. Er hat einen Doktor in Agrarökologie, Agrarsoziologie und nachhaltige Entwicklung der Universität Cordoba. Walter ist außerdem auch noch enger Partner der Heinrich-Böll-Stiftung und arbeitet immer wieder mit unserem Büro der Conosur-Region zusammen und erstellt diverse spannende Studien netterweise für uns. Herzlich willkommen, Walter, und ich freue mich sehr auf deinen Vortrag.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you, Christine. Thank you to the Heinrich Böll Foundation for the invitation to give this presentation and to be part of the Green Week this week in Berlin. I will be speaking about several issues that is engaged with the industrial agriculture transformation in Argentina and several key points that we are finding about the environmental and social effects engaged with this, and a new aspect of the consideration that we are trying to take into account that is engaged with the metabolical issues, particularly in terms of the consideration of the issue of the nutrients in this way. So in this presentation, what I'm going to show very rapidly is the relationship between the agriculture and the planetary boundaries, some of the current trends in the situation in Latin America, what we mean for us, the material flow accounting concept, and in particular the consideration and the relationship with the nutrients and other environmental impacts in terms of biodiversity. Several of you, of course, will know this picture, a very well-known picture about the limits in several key aspects that is relevant for the sustainable in the planet concept context, and I put the focus on this in several aspects of it that have direct relationship with agricultural process and transformation. The biodiversity loss, as you can see, we superate all the limits in this way. The phosphorus cycle is in a similar way. The nitrogen process that we call the cascade effect engaged with this is relevant, particularly from Latin America, because this is engaged with the soybean production, and you know that soybean production is engaged with nutrient cycle, and in this consideration with the process of nitrification in this way, and of course other key point that is relevant for Latin America in this moment that is engaged with the land use transformation in this way. So this is several key points that we consider in this way. Several of these have been considered in this last report from the UNEP panel that they had put the focus on land use change. We had not talking about in this document about nutrients. That is what I am trying to put the focus on nutrients, because I find that this document is relevant, but it's not enough for the complete discussion in this way. So we are very happy to try to incorporate the issue of virtual soils, as you are going to know about this in the coming pictures, in terms of the discussion for this, particularly for those countries that is engaged directly with farming. The farming countries, in terms of the quality of the nutrients, is relevant for the discussion too. Why? Because the best soils of the world, particularly the molly soils and the alfie soils, are only in very few places in the world. There you can see the States, the Canada and United States, and in the south Argentina, and particularly we are going to see there the River Plate Basin, the south of Africa, Ukraine and Russia, several aspects, several parts in Australia and other ones in New Zealand. And there's not enough good soils for production in this way. So this is relevant to increase the productivity, to sustain the productivity and of these soils, and not to put pressure on these soils and over-exploitate this. Because one of the other trends that you are, I'm going to go more rapidly in this way, has relationship with this, with a different utilization of the land and a different aspect in terms of what is going to happen with different countries. In terms of the war, the trends to the utilization of the incorporation of land is in the line that you can see in blue. But when we confront in the ideas of developing countries and developed world, you can see that developing countries is increasing the arable land year by year, and developed world is saving land for production in this way. So there is something like an ecological footprint between countries in terms of the discussion that is relevant to try to understand the issue, engage in the whole and in under an holistic approach, not only to consideration country by country. Instead, in this consideration, you can see in this figure the utilization of land by one side of the world, by the other side of the world. This is relevant. And it's more relevant when we consider the case of Latin America confronting the other part of the world. When you see and how we are going to explain the increasing of the growth in crop production in the trends for the coming 40 years ahead, and if we consider the issue that is engaged with yields and the arable land expansion, please see what is going to happen in the world in terms of arable land, only 9% of this expansion. But when we are going to see what is going to happen in Latin America, you can see that 40% of the arable land is in consideration in a process of transformation. This arable land is going to come practically from forest or for areas like the Chaco, as we are going to see in the coming picture. The South of America, particularly the River Plate Basin, is one of the areas that is going to be transformed and is transforming in this moment very rapidly. The River Plate Basin is part of, you can see, of the whole Paraguay, the south of Brazil, part of Bolivia, Uruguay, and the north of Argentina. This is, in this moment, the main area that is going to transform, that several companies call this area the United Republic of Soybean. Okay. This is in this moment, Syngenta, this is the company, used this as a strategy, a very bad strategy in terms of marketing, because this affects the consideration of the national borders of the country. So they had to retire this information from the, including for the information for the internet. But 4 years or 5 years ago, they called this the United Republic of Soybean in this moment. And in the reality, in terms of go ahead the borders, the reality is that the process of transformation in the area is relevant in terms of soybean production and corn production. This is only to show what in our group is working on. This is the last work of Dr. Jorge Morello, the director of GEPAMA, the group where I am. And this is only to show the last information about how we separate or ordinate the different ecoregion, and unfortunately the ecoregion that is going to transform in this moment, the Chaco húmedo, the Chaco seco, the Pampas, this is the main area of Argentina in this moment in the process of transformation, and the Espinal, this is other area that in this moment is under transformation too. And what is going to happen when we consider all the process of transformation in terms of a metabolic process, in terms of what is entering in a society and what is producing in terms of other products and different issues. Of course, the idea of material global extraction and metabolic extraction of different material, biomass, energy, fossil energy, ores, mineral and metal is well known, is well, very well known in Europe, had been used in the UNEP panel too. Of course, the issue of biomass extraction is an issue that is being calculated in different parts of the world, and is relevant, of course. In the case of Argentina, there is a very interesting paper that had been produced very years ago about this process of transformation to show it, but what C0 for Latin America had seen a similar approach, but what is not had been studied is engaged with the other approach that I'm going to comment on nutrients. The soybean in Latin America is expanding very fast, as you can see. Brazil and Argentina are leading in this issue, but particularly Paraguay is under the very strong transformation in this moment too, putting focus on soybean transformation. What is the trend of this? The food price had been a relevant issue in terms of the new demand for soybean. The good prices for soybean put pressure on the market and put pressure on the farmers, and farmers decide to go ahead with this. Farmers are not crazy people in Latin America. Farmers are using soybean because of the prices of soybean in the international market, and these are the message that they are taking in consideration as far all farmers in all parts of the world. So the good prices in the global context are the main signal for farmers in this way. Other consideration that is relevant, particularly in the case of Argentina, very different to other parts and to other countries, is that farmers in Argentina pay to the government 35% in terms of taxes directly for the exportation. So in other parts of the world, people receive, and several farmers in developed countries receive subsidies to produce. In Argentina, farmers pay 35% to produce. And they are, in some way, you can see that they can survive. But we are going to see why and the reasons in terms of natural reserve destroyment allowed to them to survive in this way. What is the trend in Argentina in this moment? As you can see, this is a real picture that is showing to you the precision farming, the no-till expansion, the pesticide fertilizer, and of course the adoption of transgenic soybean, particularly in Argentina, that in this moment is around 100% of the adoption. This is engaged directly with the utilization of herbicide. Transgenic soybean was not the core of the goal of the company at first. In the case of Argentina, you know that they had not paid payment to the companies in Argentina, but the herbicide, yes. And the herbicide, particularly the glyphosate, was a very strong process of adoption in the country that can show to you the expansion of the consume of glyphosate in the country too, and the result we are going to see in terms of the environmental issues. This is engaged. This is only to show to you the conventional process of the utilization of glyphosate in the lands of Argentina. And what is the trend in this moment? As you can see in the blue line, you can see soybean, and in the other line, the corn. You can see, of course, the expansion of soybean over corn in the trends of the production in Argentina till this year. For the other crops in this way, of course, you can consider the comparison between soybean, corn, sunflower, sorghum, and you can see the expansion of soybean over the other crops in the same season, of course, to be comparison the issues. And you can see there that this is the picture you can see in when you arrive to any surrounded of the city of Buenos Aires. This is not a picture for this year. This is 20 years ago around, okay? That book had been published in 16 years ago, Cultivos Transgénicos, Hacia Donde Vamos, and there was the main questions that is going to happen in the agriculture of Argentina in that moment, that is confirmed, unfortunately, in this moment. The appearance of resistance in weeds, the process of deforestation, the effects of glyphosate, the resistance in sorghum alepensis, and the health issues that have been commented. This is history for us, unfortunately. What a relevant question about soils an issue that had not been considered in that moment. In that moment, the issue of soils, and you know that in the case of the Argentine soils, particularly when we consider this, because for us it's relevant because these are natural soils, we can see. We are not using fertilizers till this moment. So that is one of the reasons, because for us, or for myself particularly, the discussion of what is happening with soils and the extraction of nutrients could be relevant. This is the process of expansion of soybean cultivation in Argentina from my colleague Dr. Bigliso from the INTA, and this our calculation, the first estimation of the extraction of different nutrients in the country now in terms of potassium, in terms of phosphorus, in terms of sulfur in this way. The relevant discussion is not only with macronutrients, particularly nitrogen, phosphorus, or potassium. Sulfur in this moment, and boron is other issue that is going to limit the production of soybean in the country, so this could be relevant for the discussion in the future. But what is going to happen with little and mid farmers? The prices of this type of fertilizer are really, really high for our little and mid farmers in the terms of the discussion. We are not talking about nitrogen or phosphorus. We are talking about boron, and we are talking about molybdenum and other ones. The cost of this fertilizer to replace the issue could be relevant and could be surely the little and mid farmers out of the system in this way. Why, for me, is relevant the discussion of material flow accounting for nutrients? Because of this. Because if water means life, soil are the basket that contains it. Soils and nutrients, in particular, are food directly. Good nutrients in the soils are good nutrients in the food for people. And we are not considering the issue under this discussion till this moment. So this is the key concept of what we call virtual soils in terms of the discussion of the extraction of nutrients in the grain that we produce, in the food or the biomass that we produce and that we export it to other places. In our places, this produces over-exploitation in terms of the degradation of our soils. In the places where the food or the biomass is consumed, produce contamination and produce other problems like nitrification or nitrous engage. So we are facing a very strong problem in a global context, not in a regional context, only consideration the issue of over-exploitation. So that is the main idea of the virtual soil concept. And we compare, when we compare the issues in terms of practices that allow to us the nutrients quality in the soils, of course, agroecological practice show to be more efficiently than including the conservative practice like no-till system and, of course, conventional practice that have no any consideration in terms of the discussion of the quality of the nutrient we are talking about. This is only to show the first ideas and the first picture in what we are working. We are working in this moment about in the level of provinces and in the level of department. But here you can see the extraction in terms of the main nutrients, the macronutrients from the agriculture Argentine for the soybean production. In this case, we are doing all for all the agriculture in Argentina, and there you can see the different reactions of the farmer for under different situations. Of course, the history of soybean starting in Argentina in 1970, there in previous time soybean don't exist in Argentina. The main expansion of the soybean is in this moment. This is the arrival of transgenic soybean. Here you can see the expansion in terms of the demand of nutrients or extraction of nutrients for different way in this way. But you can see this is very interesting. This is show to you the crisis, the main discussion with the farmers and the government that is still this moment, and in that discussion, farmers decide not to produce soybean in Argentina under that situation. So, in this way, this is relevant discussion that what is going to happen with the different nutrients, with the micronutrients, the picture shows a similar way in terms of the extraction of nutrients for the agricultural Argentine. Other process that is interesting is exporting of the model from the Pampas, the industrial agricultural model, to other places that are not the Pampas. Okay, in the north you can see there the Chaco region. I call this pampeanization in some way. And the process of pampeanization shows to you that the people that is involved, that is not involved with the agricultural sector, is really affected. Because what we are not considering in some way, when we speak about deforestation, we are worried about the process, okay, we are going to lose the forest and issues engaged. But they are live people, and peasants, and indigenous people, particularly in the Chaco. We are not discussing in this moment the sustainability of the Pampas. We can discuss the possibility of the Pampas in other way. But the Chaco is not the same issue, and the Chaco is a real problem in this moment. You can see this picture. This is all in this moment a desert that is converted after this. This is a destruction in the north of the Pampa. This is the effect of the process of deforestation. And you can see the result there. This is the mouth of the River Plate Basin, confronting the city of Buenos Aires there. You can see the effects, the physical effects of the extraction of nutrients in that way. And this is other picture that shows to you the problem that we are facing in the south when we produce the process of the agricultural extraction in this moment. So we had an anthropogenic extraction of nutrients, and we had a physical or natural extraction or losing of nutrients in this way. So that is one of the reasons, because the agriculture in Argentina is not sustainable under this condition. Other issue is engaged with agrobiodiversity. The effect and the pressure of agrobiodiversity is relevant, particularly in terms of the utilization of glyphosate. This is Sorghum alepensis. This picture is historic tool. This is the first time of applying transgenic soybean and glyphosate in Argentina. This is San Antonio Areco. This is around more than 15 years ago. And there you can see the Sorghum alepensis control in that moment. Farmers start year by year to use glyphosate more and more. And the effect is this. In the north of the country, this is not a crop. This is Sorghum alepensis. For farmers, you know that is a real problem. For this farmer, he cannot produce anymore because the cost to control this is relevant for this. This man has lost their land. And this is the effect in this moment, the appearance of resistance in different, not only in Johnson grass in this moment, the appearance of resistance in different weeds, practically in all the north of Argentina in this moment. This is a relevant problem for farmers in the coming time, of course, recognized by the industrial agriculture too, and of course, they have the other offer to control this with new crops in this way. This is the north. This is the north of Argentina in this moment. Of course, this is all forest previously time. This is a picture of only months where I had that. And you can see there, that highway there, only prepare for the exportation of soybean. Okay? That is what is happening in the north in this moment. Only one comment about organic and agroecological, because in Argentina, you know, we are not producing only transgenic soybean, we are producing other issues. But organic and agroecological approach is different for the case of Argentina, because in terms of the agroecological discussion, we are incorporating other issues like social and culture and issues that are engaged with land access. But look at the picture. In this picture, you can see that organic harvest for the case of Argentina is relevant, and more relevant is this, the picture of lands. One of the reasons is Argentina can produce more organic farming, of course. Of course, we can produce this from one year to the other one. Why we are not doing this? Who is buying these products? if we produce in this way. Okay? This is the response for the people when the people say, okay, farmers in Argentina are crazy. No, they are not crazy. They are trying to survive like farmers in all parts of the world. What is going to happen in the future? More transgenic crops. This is the promotion of the company. This is what is going to happen in this moment till this situation. I had commented to you the problem for farmers in terms of agroecological issues had related with logistics and markets. And this is the final comments to you. Of course, the River Plate Basin is in the process of transformation and a strong transformation in this moment. Cash crop are transforming the face of the agricultural model in Argentina. Nutrient depletion is increasing too, unfortunately, in this moment. And material flow accounting for nutrients particularly could be relevant. And I think that in the coming months, we are going to show to people the results of our research. Thank you very much.